10 of the holy tribes of Bnei Israel, they've been mixed between the nations. A lot of people that are coming today back to Judaism and looking for the source are actually from those families, from those holy tribes. And the Mashiach, when Mashiach will come and reveal himself to the nations, he's going to bring all of those exiled tribes, all of the lost tribes, back to Am Israel, and we're going to help them all to convert. So when we meet those people, when we see souls that are not necessarily Jewish, but they have that holy desire to come closer to Kedusha, and they're seeking for faith, and they want to know God, we need to understand something unique is inside of them. It can be that today they're Christians. It can be that today they're Muslims. It can be that today they're worshiping idols. But if they have such a strong desire to search for Hashem, it need to turn on that light bulb for you to say, hey, maybe I can help that brother somehow. Maybe I can help that sister somehow. Maybe there is something that I can do. Because to have a desire for Hashem Yitbarach, this is something that came out from Yaakov. And like we said, Yaakov, he brought down to the world the 12 tribes, that 10 of them went lost to Spain, to Africa, to America, to Europe, to a lot of places, that to the Muslim countries and to the Far East also. We have a lot of testaments of people that met a lot of tribes and groups of people today that are keeping a lot of rules that you see very easily that the roots of those behaviors and customs are coming from biblical time. And also, we know that the modern world today is going to a place that a lot of religious people, even from other religions, are being secular, and they're dropping their old customs and behaviors. So the fact that today those people are not holding the rules of their own ancestors and they're totally secular doesn't mean that they're not still from those same holy tribes that lost their Judaism but still haven't lost their holy soul. Maybe they're not holding in the same level, but their heart is still that desiring heart for the Creator, for faith. So if a person grew up in a Christian environment or in a Muslim environment, so where you want him to look for God? If a person today, you see that he's seeking for the Creator and he wants to find God and he's looking for that, and that's his main desire in life, to come closer to Hashem, you need to know for sure that that person is somehow connected to us. There is no doubt about it. Or else what he's doing, you know, is that if he's a hunter, so you know he's from the tribe of, he's from the nation of Edom. If he's a thief, so you know he's from the nation of another one. Everyone got his nature. But us, Bnei Israel, we have that holy desire to look for Hashem. Today, Just to get the numbers right, after all of the exiled and being chased by the church for so many years, and so many Jews been murdered and slaughtered during the years, and the Holocaust that took 6 million Jews from our nation, and today we're something like 15 million people. And with those 6, today we were supposed to be something like 25. In those 70 years, we would multiply more. And it was the frum part of Am Israel. So those are blessed families with a lot of children. So we would be at least 25 million people as a nation supposed to be. So, and this is only the tribe of Yehudah. So this is one tribe. So you need to make that number times 12. And this is how many Israeli souls you have in the world. So every one of them got their assumptions, and every one of them got their opinions, and some of them are calling themselves Hebrews, and some of them calling themselves everyone got their way of thinking that's been affected by the monastery, by Islam, and by a lot of things. The exile took sacrifices. So we need to look beyond the physicality and the knowledge that people have, and to see the holy desire of those souls to come closer to Judaism. We need to have those eyes to be those messengers to every place that we go to look for mevakshamana, for people that are looking for faith. We need to understand our mission as people that learn Torah, as people that got the message and the wisdom from God. We need to understand that the Creator, He loves all of His creations, and He wants everyone to know Him and everyone to walk in His path and to serve Him. And we need to be those ambassadors. We need to be those ones to be light to the nations and to spread the light and to spread that opportunity for people to come closer to God.